so honored and so blessed to be found this opportunity. And today what I take you through is a little bit of a journey. My sister Miriam says, what is the secret? Well, guess what? There's no secret, okay? However, there is a process, okay? So that is what I'm going to take you through. And hopefully we'll have enough time to take some Q&A, okay? All right, so the first thing I did when I joined this business, remember, I had zero business experience. On top of that, I've never, ever heard of network marketing, never mind doing it. So the first thing I did is what is called tripod of belief, okay? I needed to build my belief. And how do I do that? The first one is believe in the industry. What is network marketing? What is MLM? And while doing my study on the industry, I came across many conflicting and contradicting statements from different people. Some saying, oh, I have done it, it's a complete scam, do not do it. And others saying, I do it and I'm doing well. I always talk about this during our Somali webinar. God has blessed us with his brain. It is very important that we use. So for me, it didn't make any sense. Two people, they're in the same company, they have the same products, one is successful, one is not. So the question is, what is the hidden secret? And you know what I realized? It's only because of the fact that people who do not succeed in our industry did not understand that this is work. If you look at the term network, most of us know net, right? It's the people that surround you. But there's work. This is work. I was just reading before I got in here an article that talked about why some are successful and some aren't. And they said the ones that are successful are the ones that are most focused when it comes to helping others, okay? As Zig Ziglar would say, help enough people, get what they want, you get what you want. It's all about helping. So for me, when I joined this business, if you look at my background, I was doing 10 years helping my community. So that is my field. It's all about building others first. Then within that, what happened is I also got myself built. It's incredible. Okay, so that's number one, is to believe in the industry. I also learned that our industry introduces the highest amount of millionaires every single year. That's right. No other industry can come close to it. Okay, so once I bought the industry and I understood the industry, the second thing is believe in the company. I've done a lot of study on starting with our CEO and founder, Ramin Masgarnou. Who is he? What is his background? Is this someone that can take me to what I'm looking at, which is generating enough wealth so that I can bring more change into my community? I've done that. I've looked up on none other than our SVP, Sinas Human. Who is she, right? Because these are the people that are leading our ship. I wanted to learn everything about them, okay? Lastly, but not least, believe in yourself, okay? In other words, having self-confidence, okay? Whatever that you believe about yourself today, is exactly what will happen, okay? So your confidence and your belief and your mindset has to match with what you're looking for, okay? Just to give you a little example on confidence, not too long ago, I was watching a short documentary on Priyanka Chopra. If any of you follow Bollywood, you will know her. She's actually the only Bollywood actress who broke into Hollywood, and now she has her own show, okay? And she lives in the States, okay? Now, Priyanka Chopra became Miss India at the age of 19, okay? 18 or 19, I can't remember, one of them. And what she shared, her story was just phenomenal, jaw-dropping. Maybe if I have time, I'll put it here before I leave so you can watch it yourself. And she says, when she competed for the pageant, she connected with a lot of the ladies that were competing with her. And she said, I remember there were ladies there or young women, at the time they were not ladies yet, young women or other girls who were more prettier than her and who were more educated and more articulate than her. Yet she won, okay? Now what did she do? She went back to the judges to find out what worked for her. Because in her mind, this is the beginning of greatness to come. She did not rest and say, this is it. I won the pageant, Miss India. This is, be all, end all. No. For her, it's like this is the start of many things to come. So she went back to the judges and she asked them, she said, you know, there are ladies that I think were more deserving. Can you please tell me me, what is it that made you select me? And you know what they said? It's because you had the most confidence. Confidence, my sisters and brothers, is really, really what's gonna set you out from everybody else. Okay? She said, from that day on, I'm sure that I talked and walked and carried myself differently than everyone else. Okay? Now we gotta be careful not to mix confidence with arrogance, right? Because arrogance will do the exact opposite. Confidence is all about believing you, where arrogance is showing off consistently. There's a difference, okay? So let's not mix the two, okay? So those are the three things. Now for me, in order to get that confidence, what I have done is I actually interviewed the top income earners in our company. It's starting with none other than Mr. Rene Liao, our youngest millionaire. I remember when I connected with Rene, he only had about 15 minutes. It was right before dinner time with his family, and I love how organized he is. Dinner time with family means dinner time for him, right? So he said, Ifrah, I have very few minutes. I hope you don't mind. I said, no problem. Even if you talk to me 1 minute, I don't care. I want to hear. So he shared his story with me, and he told me how he joined our company at the age of 27, and by the time he was 31, 4 years later, he hit his first million. Now, I remember sitting there. Rene was raised in Toronto, okay? I grew up in Ottawa. We're around the same age. In my mind, I'm thinking, oh my goodness, if Rene did it, I can certainly do it, okay? So Rene was the first person I talked to. The other people I talked to was Sherry Liao, the first woman millionaire in our company, okay? Who's right now pretty much retired, and she's, you know, in California with her little baby. I spoke to Renee, and she gave me an entire 30 minutes. I wanted to know her story. I also spoke with my sister Kafina all the way in Nigeria. My sister Stella was talking about the team in Nigeria. Kafina is one of the people I reached out to. And as busy as she was able to share her story. And you know one thing? At the end of the call, Ronan was another one. At the time, Reza was actually in Kenya, building Kenya. Okay, the same market that inspired me to get into this business. He was away. So I talked to everybody else. And you know, once they shared their story with me, I ended with one question. What is one advice you can give me today that you think has played a very key role in your success? And they all had the same answer. And you know what it was? To never, ever, ever miss any training and any events. Okay? Events and trainings is exactly how you build your business. So that is that. Now that I have gathered all the information I needed, now it was time for me to set a target. What is my target? Our CEO always talks about, don't set goals, set targets. Why? Because goals are things that you like to achieve, but targets are things that you're gonna achieve no matter what. There is no excuse, right? So the first target I had was to quit my government job within the first year to two. It didn't matter what it took, I wanted to leave that government job. Okay, now that I have left, a lot of people ask me, you know, was it hard to make that decision? I'm like, are you kidding me? For 2 years, I lived as if I had no government job. Okay, I lived and breathed the life that I have today for 2 years, way before I got there.